Dark and Deep invites you to experience a first-person cosmic horror adventure centered around puzzles and exploration. A conspiracy podcast draws you into a vividly illustrated world filled with intrigue and terror, where you can discover hidden secrets and horrors through mystical frames bestowed upon you by a peculiar observer. You take on the role of Samuel Judge, navigating a perilous and dimly lit environment where survival is key. And you're not the only one lurking in the darkness. Sinister creatures are eager to snuff out your light. Join me if you dare, as I unravel the mysteries of this illustrated world, showcasing stunning artwork that brings the darkest depths of imagination to life. Whether you're a fan of horror, fantasy, or the unexplained, this exploration promises to ignite your curiosity and spark your imagination. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more thrilling content that dives deep into the shadows of creativity. Let me know in the comments what aspects of this dark world fascinated you the most.
An informant from deep inside the belly of the beast. The trail has seemed cold for some time, but today everything changed. Coming up, Dark and Deep. Killer on the run. Who is the mysterious driver of the black panel van racing away from the violent scene earlier today? Who is the new character entering this epic story? Who is Samuel Judge? Dear listener, the weather is turning cold, and so is this case. Hazy details are hidden behind storm clouds on the horizon. We may never fully know what happened to Abby Reynolds. Lost, dead, or just vanished. Was she in too deep? Did she know too much? Perhaps she doesn't want to be found. Perhaps Abby is living a life somewhere far away, where the sun is shining, listening to this broadcast right now. Happy to hear that I'm putting this investigation to rest. Hey, Abby, if you're out there.
But those of us who are truly awake,
we never rest.
No mystery is ever truly put to bed. We know that the work is far from over. The eye in the sky, the powers that be in Washington, D.C. They are always watching us, so we will be watching them. Tune in next time on Dark and Deep. Podcast is brought to you by Dave's Shave and Save, a monthly razor subscription for men who value clean shave dirt cheap. Go to davesshaveandsave.com, use promo code AWAKE for 5% off a yearly subscription. Ever since the last case went cold, I've been thinking a lot about death. I know people have their opinions on what lies beyond this mortal coil, and I won't claim to know the answer. But I, for one, hope it's nothing. Nothing at all. That sounds nice to me. It gives me a sense of peace. It's so final. There's something comforting about that. No more crossroads, wrong turns, or losing your way in the dark. Just the end of the road. I made a promise to myself that the next time I started an investigation, I would finish it. Reach my destination. I deserve that. You deserve that. I've seen the comments, read the reviews. The truth is, I agree with you. I don't know if I can endure another unsolved mystery, another ellipses, lost yet again in the tangle of roads that lead to nowhere, while the forces of evil wash in the shadows. Dear listener, this time will be different. I've found my way. I've been following the signs for some time now, and I've discovered a path forward. This time, I'm in the driver's seat. I'm taking risks, pushing myself to the limit. I can't promise you where this road will lead, but I can promise you this. It's going to be a wild ride. Take the ride with me. Hopefully it doesn't take us off a cliff. See you next time on Dark and Deep. Brought to you by Vital Vitamins. All of the nutrients you need in one convenient pill, 7 times daily. Helps you lose weight paired with diet and exercise. Dear listener, it's a cold one out there. I hope you're staying warm. Over here in the studio, we've got something heating up. Today, we begin a new series, Dark Machinations. Do you ever wonder who the Illuminati really are? I know. Don't roll your eyes. Stay with me. I promise. You don't know where this is going. Listen, they obviously exist. The elites, the billionaires with forest retreats hidden from the world, the remote islands where generals, presidents, and kings conspire in secret. But what about the foot soldiers, the handmaidens to power, the normal folk? Lately, I'm beginning to think, maybe the Illuminati aren't all shadows and mystery. Maybe the agents of chaos are also masters of conformity. Just like us, hiding in plain sight, in the mundane existence of everyday life, your office, your home. What if your neighbor is not who they seem? What if your coworker at the water cooler is hiding a dark secret? What if your slimy boss is more than just a bore who makes you work late on a Friday? What if he's a snake in a soup? What if he's studying you? As you sit for 9 hours in the sickly glow of your computer monitor, what if he's watching, waiting? This series is about those who hide in plain sight and the evil that they do under our noses. A strange, mysterious device designed for psychological torture. Built by your neighbors and friends. A network of conspirators, accountable to no one, playing God in their laboratories. An invisible menace slithering in secret all across our nation, ready to unhinge his jaw and swallow you whole.
Thank you.
I know. It's a lot to take in. It seems unbelievable. Like the stuff of science fiction. But I assure you, it is fact. And it's happening right now, right here in not-so-sunny Virginia. Tune in next time to Dark and Deep. Brought to you by our very own local Virginia favorite, Deep State Steak and Cheese. Try the Mozzarella Industrial Complex. Layers and layers of artisan mozzarella cheese over the crispiest chicken parm you ever had. Topped with our top secret sauce. Pick one up for lunch today.
maybe a year.
Try the mozzarella industrial complex. Layers and layers and layers and layers of artisan mozzarella cheese. Steak. Steak and cheese. Layers and 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 layers of parts of mozzarella cheese. Thank you. Dear listener, I've been doing this for a long time. I've seen a lot of darkness. Each investigation brings a new challenge. To be completely honest, this one terrifies me. Who would want to live in fear of their neighbor, in suspicion of their friends, looking over their shoulder in the office, wondering? Truth is more important than our fears. But what is that truth? Dear listener, it reveals itself more every day. Here is what we know so far. But we live in a country of countless, nameless, faceless facilities. Do you really know what goes on in the bellies of these steel and concrete beasts? Even here in beautiful Virginia, perhaps especially here, in the shadow of the military-industrial complex. ultimate question. Did they actually manage to build one? Someone had to get their hands dirty. I guess I just thought it might as well be me. I just kept thinking about the cost. Not so much the money. Sure, to secretly build something like this machine must be astronomically expensive, paid for by you, the taxpayer. But what about the human cost? A device like this doesn't get built without people getting hurt. Who among us is so naive to think they have not killed for it? Innocent blood has been shed, ground up in the gears of this depraved machine. It's demonic what they do. What they want, to twist a person's mind into a state of horrified unreality, to shatter your grasp on truth, to steal your happy, healthy thoughts from you and replace them with sorrow and sickness. Dear listener, the forces of evil must be stopped. Drag them kicking and screaming into the light. They won't come quietly, but exposing them is worth any cost. So as you drive down your street, think, how much do you really know about your neighbors? Can you come home after a long day of work and just close your eyes and sleep? Or do you lie awake, wondering what they do in the shadows? What would you be willing to do to exorcise the demons next door? I'll show you what I've done. Next time on Dark and Deep. Brought to you by Trusty VPN. Your online privacy should be a priority. For the low price of $9 a year, you can keep the surveillance state at bay and watch Korean Netflix whenever you want. I'd like to start this episode with a personal message to a particularly dear listener. I haven't been able to reach you the last few days. Maybe you don't want to talk to me. I understand that. Things haven't exactly gone as planned. Maybe you're in a dark place. In a fog. Maybe you've been swallowed up by the beasts that dwell in the shadows. Maybe I'm next. Confession is good for the soul. I want to get a few things off my chest. It's me, Truth Seeker, the voice of your favorite podcast, but also your only friend. I'm truly sorry that I wasn't honest with you. I know you're a fan of the show, but telling you my true identity felt like it would open us both up to too much risk. Using you to obtain the documents was wrong, I know. But the truth is worth any sins we must commit. I really thought after it was over, you would be proud to know you had been part of something so exciting, so important. But it wasn't supposed to happen like this. I'm sorry it's taken such a grim turn. I know you must be scared. I know I am. Maybe one day the darkness closes around us. Maybe the thick, creeping fog steals the breath from our lungs. A stranger in the shadows sends us both to the great beyond. But this day has not yet turned to night. We must press on. Dear listener, after years and years of truth-seeking, questioning everything, exposing what they do in the shadows, it finally happened. They noticed. I guess I would be flattered if it wasn't so terrifying. But it won't be that easy to stop. The truth has been buried for far too long, slithering and sneaking underground. It's time to reveal it to the world. Damn the consequences. I'm going off the grid. I'm going dark. The sun has yet to fully set on this story. We may not have much daylight left. So let's get this show on the road. Listener, after all the watching, all the waiting, all the dead ends, dead air, and death threats, finally, they emerge from the shadows.